folks, welcome back. This is your live verdict. Now, winning this competition gives you massive amounts of exposure and legions of fans, and one young man has used such a position to work out some pretty inspiring stuff is Mr. Guy Sebastian. You remember him. He recently travelled to Africa on what was a pretty special mission.
Yeah, Guy spent 3 weeks in Uganda and Rwanda with the charity World Vision to not only see what good work that organisation is doing in the region, but also to go on a bit of a musical quest of his own, to go and find the roots of the music that he loves so much.
Yeah, and then we've whacked together a documentary. Well, not us, obviously, but they have whacked together a documentary that's going to be on 10 very, very soon. But to give you a bit of a taste of what Guy got up to, let's have a look.
I guess for me, a lot of the support that I received in Australia through Idol and through my musical career, it would just be a crime if I didn't do something and if I didn't take up the responsibility as an artist to kind of give back a little bit. And for me, that's what being here is all about, to link in with World Vision and to really see firsthand the work that they're doing and what I'm believing in as an artist too. Which one's good? This one right here, right?
I knew of World Vision through child sponsorship, but I was keen to see the other work they did, especially when it came to food shortages in Africa. I'd heard a lot about the crisis, but I felt baffled. There seemed to be food in these markets. So how is it possible for people to be going hungry? My guide Simon Peter explained that despite the food I saw here, due to the long-running internal conflict raging in the north, the impact of the HIV/AIDS epidemic and the ongoing African drought, millions of people simply couldn't access food or water. So Uganda, like many other African countries, was in serious crisis.
It's very, very heavy stuff there from Mr. Sebastian. Don't be surprised if there's actually some musical influence from that trip on his next single, which is actually due out in early December. Can't wait for it. If you want to have a look at that documentary, it's pretty life-changing for Guy. In fact, you can check out when it's going to be on Inside Idol this Thursday, 7:30.
Yeah, he's the coolest ever. And most inspiring guy I think I've ever met. All right.
This week, we're catching up with our very first idol, Guy Sebastian, who invited me for an exclusive peek at his amazing new beach house.
Hey, thanks for having us into your house, Guy.
Oh, that's okay.
I love your kitchen. I mean it.
Oh, thank you.
It's really stylish and sleek and
I'm
clean.
Glad that I cleaned it. And then my little band. That's my little band that I take on tour with me.
I love this little guy.
Little guy. It's mini me.
It is mini you. Hey, I heard you put a recording studio on here.
I did. You want to check it out?
Yeah? Is that an offer? Because I'll take it.
Guy Sebastian.
It's been a wild ride for Guy in the 2 years since he made Australian history becoming our very first idol. He's toured the world writing and recording music, and now Adelaide's favourite son has chosen to settle in Sydney and work on a new album.
So this is a studio.
Oh, this is great.
Yeah, it's a nice little space. I'll probably record most of the third album here. So yeah, it's cool just having it at my house.
So what about musically? What are you doing right now?
Right now I'm just writing and just recording and just trying to get that done. I don't want to rush this next record. I want every song to be, you know, really, really wow.
And I was so excited that Guy offered me a preview of one of his new original songs about his experience as a superstar.
When I won Idol and when everything happened to me that did, you can get lost in it a little bit and you lose a sense of reality. And I almost got caught up in the whole fame side of things. And so I wrote this song and it's all about losing someone that you love because, you know, you've got famous and you've got everything that you've wanted for so long and the one thing that you really, really want is gone kind of thing. So it's called Everything in This Whole World.
You and me, it used to be all about you and me. It ceased to be when I got famous. Yeah, we had our dreams, we had our plans. But suddenly I thought I was the man. How could I be so ignoramus?
That kind of deal. Blah, blah, blah. And so, yeah.
I love it. I love it.
It's really raw, though.
It's raw, but yeah. I can't believe how good that sounds. So raw. That's awesome. No, seriously, it's great.
Guy's just back from a tour of Africa as an ambassador for the charity World Vision.
For me, a whole big part of the trip was getting to the roots of soul music, and you really did see that. Like, the girls and that would dance, and the drums would beat, and but the girls would full-on booty shake, and you see where Beyonce gets. And they've been doing that for, like, centuries, and it was awesome. It was just the best musical experience I've ever had, I reckon.
Guy's keen to put his high profile to use for a good cause.
I really believed in what World Vision were doing, but hadn't actually seen it yet. And for me, going over there and seeing what they were doing and meeting all those kids and meeting all the people that I met, hearing the stories that I met, was just mind-blowing. Like, it was something that I wanted to do since I was little. So.
The doco actually has some really powerful, confronting images in it. You couldn't come away from an experience like that and not be different, could you?
To be totally honest, about 90% of it is cut. Like, we had to leave the bad stuff out so that we could kind of, fit it into something that kids could watch as well. But it's still quite controversial, quite confronting. And the things that are stories I heard over there will never leave me. Images that I saw will never leave me.
Once in a lullaby.
You're a really humble guy, but the work that you're actually doing out there and what you're putting out there is nothing short of fantastic.
You can see Guy's doco on the 10 Network very soon. Check the web for details.
In Africa, many children are orphaned. Thousands of families live in hunger, and many more are affected by war. Find out how you can help. Call 133240 or visit worldvision.com.au now.